I'm going to lose my mind. I seriously feel like I can't take one more day of this. It feels like the same day, every day. I feel claustrophobic, like I'm literally aching to break out. How long will it be this way? Forever? I feel like I can't breathe. And yet, I know there is something more hidden in this place, in this time. And I know how I handle this time will determine what I have to show for it when the season is through. I know something beautiful can come out of it, can come out of me. But only if I lean into the discomfort. Only if I yield my need to control it. From the Diary of a Planted Seed.
I'm Christoph Brown, and I will be hosting tonight's tribute to the class of 2020. Senior year is a special time, a time that many look forward to for years, and it's really a culminating event and a transitioning event as you end one phase of your life and begin another. And as we all know, this year did not end like you probably hoped it would, and many of those milestone events were lost or at least hopefully delayed. But tonight is all about you, the class of 2020, as we try to honor you and your accomplishments the best way that we can. Now, I'm assuming that we all are practicing social distancing and are 6 feet away from the screen, so I can feel comfortable losing that and tossing that aside. Tonight's ceremony is all about you, the graduates and members of the class of 2020. This is our opportunity as a faculty and staff here at St. Croix Prep to honor your hard work, your dedication, your determination, your perseverance over the past year, 4 years, in your career here at St. Croix Prep. You will see many awards being presented by various faculty members, and we'll announce the awards that you selected, the Student Choice Awards, where you recognized the peers that made the biggest impact on your time and experience here at St. Croix Prep, as well as the faculty members that did the same. You'll also get to see special performances by the Chamber Choir and by members of the band. And the moment that all of us look forward to every year at the senior dinner, of course, is the senior slideshow, which will be at the conclusion of this ceremony. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the tribute to the class of 2020. First, we have our welcoming message by Principal Mr. Sakuraisen.
Good evening, faculty, parents, and students. My name is Andrew Sakurai. What's my name? Good evening, faculty, parents, and students. I'd like to begin today's ceremony by thanking all of you who are watching today and to honor the hard work and dedication of our students. This event was designed to provide a platform where we recognize the many students in our upper school contribute and encapsulate the mission of our school in a variety of ways. St. Croix Prep is a place where all students are pushed. And while we cannot recognize everyone for everything, we did want to take this opportunity to highlight some of the student achievements earned throughout the year.
I want to thank Mr. Sakuraisen for having such a big impact on me in my 4 years of high school. Thank you for genuinely caring about each of you students and for keeping your office open and available at all times. I will always remember the advice you gave me and the fun memories and times that made high school the best. Thank you for being the best principal.
Hey everyone. I can't even believe I'm saying this right now, but we made it. How crazy is that? I can't believe 13 years flies by that fast. And even though we might not be getting the ending we all expected and the ending we dreamed of since we were little, I just want to say that I'm so proud of all of us and everything that we stand for as a class. Every year we've spent together, every pet fest, every dance, every club meeting, and every other day in between will be some of our fondest memories and our most favorite childhood moments. I could not have asked for a better group of people to share all these memories with. And I'm so, so thankful I've gotten the chance to get to know each and every one of you. And I wish you all the very best of luck in the future. Congrats, everyone. I'm going to miss you all so much. Bye.
We'll begin this evening with our first awards in the academics. Here to present the math, science, social studies, and English awards are Ms. Riggles, Dr. Schreier, Mr. Gottschalk, and Ms. Bransford.
This year's recipients of the Sigma Excellence Award in Mathematics possess and have demonstrated not just excellent in mathematical content, but a desire to excel in the field. These students, in addition to representing the core values of model prep student, are also strong, helpful, and enthusiastic participants in the classroom and are continuously conducting inquiry and investigation. They are not afraid to theorize and go the extra mile to explore and experiment. To the Sigma Award recipients, math is more than just numbers. This year's outstanding mathematicians are Grace Mullen and Will North. Congratulations.
The Science Award goes to those individuals who go beyond the learning of the content of their science class. These students have a genuine interest in the area and are willing to take the extra time to understand the material and see how that material fits in with a greater context. These individuals ask questions, lead discussion, and express a genuine joy for science. The winners for this year's Science Award goes to Grace Hildrum and Quinn Alabuni. Congratulations, ladies.
Oh, hello. What was that? Two award recipients for social studies? Wow, I'll have to think about that. So the people we pick, they would have an outstanding commitment and pursuit of excellence in social studies classes, right? And would they have shown a strong personal connection and interest in the social studies discipline? Okay. And they would likely take initiative to go beyond expectations and exhibit like critical thinking skills that require the ability to evaluate major concepts and controversies and sources. Okay. And just to be clear, would these students have freely shared their ability with other students and sought out areas to expand their own knowledge? Okay. It's getting to be a little bit more clear. I got it. I know the perfect two. Clara Brecker, Hans Gebauer, hands down. You both brought something so special to our social studies classes over the last few years. I personally, on behalf of the other social studies teachers, want to thank you for bringing your passion, interest, and curiosity into our subject areas. Thank you so much. It's been such a pleasure to have you. Way to go.
Hi, it is Ms. Bransford here, and I would like to present the winners for this year's English Department Awards for seniors. So this year, we have two winners. Both of them are extremely creative. I have been so impressed with reading their writing and with their classroom conversations and contributions in seminar. They are thoughtful readers and really interesting writers. So the English Awards this year go to senior Will North and Anna Nelson. Thanks so much. Congratulations.
We'll continue the ceremonies this evening by presenting the next set of academic awards. But before we do that, I wanted to recognize the winners of the Honor Athlete and Honor Participant Awards. These awards were awarded last week by the Activities Department. So we wanted to wish our congratulations to the Honor Athlete Award winners, Will North and Madison Marks. And the new award, the Honor Participant, an award that was created to recognize those who excelled in various extracurricular clubs and activities. The first recipients of the Honor Participant Awards, congratulations to Anna Nelson and Isaac Woodman. We'll continue the program with the academic awards for the subjects of Spanish, physical education, Latin, and art.
Thank you. academic achievement that is based on student performance, overall progress, and participation that go beyond the average course expectations. Recipients demonstrate a unique ability to excel in understanding and utilizing the language, both within the classroom and in the community. The recipients of this year's award are supportive classmates who love to share their cultural knowledge with the class. This year, the Spanish award goes to Miriam Cooper and Anna Nelson. You two are hashtag Spanish student goals. How do you turn this off? Nailed it. That was so good. I only needed to get half dressed and nobody could tell. My video is definitely going to be the best one.
All hail Natalie Visich and Emma Wolf, this year's winners of the SCPA Latin Award. Nos vergillum lecturi te salutamus.
Hi everyone, I am excited to present this year's Physical Education Award. This award is presented to a student for their outstanding participation, sportsmanship, and enthusiasm in their PE classes. This year's recipients are Barrett Benson, Madison Marks, and Emma Wearing. Congratulations, you guys. Might I add, they have all been in multiple classes this year. Thank you for your dedication to PE.
The Visual Art Award recognizes the artistic excellence and creativity of individuals who show outstanding effort in their artistic development by displaying the following qualities: depth, breadth, originality, and creativity. This year we've selected three individuals for this award, which is unusual, but Ms. Moccasin and I felt that our two female art award recipients showed very different styles and approaches to what it means to be an artist. Our first award is presented to Izzy Gardner, who has been in many areas of the visual arts program at SCPA. In her 4 years in the upper school, Izzy has found her way through drawing, ceramics, painting, and the yearbook. In her senior year alone, she was in drawing 2, painting 1, and the yearbook, which is a full year course. She has been a member of the National Art Honors Society for 3 years, which she displayed strong leadership and service in all events and workshops. As I have worked with Izzy in the last year, I have watched her develop and strengthen her voice and style within her art. Her work often carries a minimalist and elegant style. She takes great pride and care in her work, often spending extra time to complete assignments and take it beyond their requirements. Through her studies, service, and passion for art, her style and interests reflect a career or related field in the graphic arts. Our second award is presented to Lauren Chavala. Between Ms. Mock, Lauren, and I, we often joke that she lives down here in the art room. In her time at SCPA, she has taken many classes in the visual arts program, such as drawing, ceramics, digital photography, art seminar, painting, AP 2D art and design, and an independent study in art, exhausting nearly every class in the visual art department. Lauren has versed herself in many art forms and has shown originality and creativity. She is often found hunched over her work, perfecting each detail. She applies reflection and gives well thought out and encouraging feedback to others in critiques. Her voice and passion come through in her artwork. She has developed her own unique style and incorporates her interest in art history, trends, and influences and techniques into every piece. Her voice and passion is evident in all aspects of her as an artist. Our final award goes to Will North. Will has also spent a lot of time taking a variety of art classes in his time at SCPA. He excelled in digital photography, drawing 1 and 2, and this year pursued a full year independent study focusing on portraiture and landscape using pen, ink, and pastel. Will is self-driven, curious about technique, and expanding his love for drawing. With each new piece, Will dedicated time to a specific application or process to make sure it was perfect for the artwork. His commitment to the craft goes beyond technique and process to studying famous photographers to help him translate the qualities of a landscape in a drawing. He has shown service by expanding extracurricular art activities to our SCPA community through his leadership in National Art Honor Society.
I just want to say a quick thanks to all staff who has helped me throughout the years, helped me grow as a person, and teach me and support me no matter what. Thank you.
Up next, a special performance by the Chamber Choir here at St. Croix Prep as they perform The Road Home by Stephen Paulus. After that performance, we'll continue the awards by awarding the Band, Orchestra, and Choir Award.
The John Philip Sousa Award is the pinnacle of achievement in a high school band. Introduced in 1955 to honor the top student in the high school band, the Sousa Award recognizes superior musicianship and outstanding dedication, dependability, loyalty, and cooperation. While playing both the horn and the trumpet, Connor Parr has pursued and attained musical excellence while pushing others to do the same. I am pleased to recognize Connor as the winner of the 2020 John Philip Sousa Band Award. The Louis Armstrong Jazz Award was inaugurated in 1974 and honors the outstanding jazz musician at each high school. It recognizes superior musicianship and outstanding dedication, dependability, loyalty, and cooperation. Isaac McMullen has been a versatile musical driving force throughout his high school career. Just as Louis Armstrong was comfortable in front of an audience, Isaac lives and breathes music while maintaining humility and having fun. I'm pleased to recognize Isaac as the winner of the 2020 Louis Armstrong Jazz Award.
I have the great fortune this evening of presenting on behalf of Mr. Jeske the Orchestra Award for this year. Congratulations to Sadie Gilmeister on being the outstanding leader in orchestra. Congratulations.
The Maestro Award recognizes a senior male and female singer that has shown outstanding leadership and vocal ability in their time in choir. This year's recipients have certainly met this criteria. Accomplishments of these individuals include serving as vice president and president on our choir council, participating in all-state choir, superior ratings at contests, and being involved in extracurricular ensembles and musicals. Most importantly, these individuals have shown incredible work ethic. They constantly strive to make the group better and always lead by example. It is my pleasure to award this year's Maestro Award to Oliver Yoakum and Anna Nelson.
Hello, members of the class of 2020. Here's a bit of advice for you. Join AAA if you haven't already. Those guys will change your car tire or bring you a tank of gas if you need it. It's a great service. If you bring a bicycle to college or to an apartment, be sure to lock it up. Don't get caught with 20 people in your dorm room on your friend's 20th birthday party. Someone will make a big deal out of it.
Post-spring break, a new normal settles in. As weeks passed, it became a struggle to remain engaged. Decreasing motivation and fewer assignments submitted, the only thing that seemed to be increasing was our hair. 10 weeks later, we all look like we've made one too many trips to the salad bar. Sure, some of you show off your flow with pride, others gave in and chopped the salad, while others simply muted the Zoom camera. But SCPA has managed to capture that look, and like a good hockey flow video, we want to share our struggle with
COVID hair 2020.
Seniors, we love you. We miss you. I even miss my morning hallway walk to beg you to get to first hour on time. It's funny how some of you have better hair now than you did on a typical school morning at 9:27. Or maybe it was 9:31, right, Oliver? In fact, some of you, your look hasn't really changed. Oh, you may seem put together for every Zoom session, but we see your split ends. You're not fooling anyone. For others, the struggle has been legit. Take a look at Gracie with the red cabbage bunned up. She even threw in her own comparison to the Incredibles villain. Here's Izzy, who decided to let the flow go. Put down the scissors, you might need a weed whacker. And Will, whoa, can't control the waving fields of grain. Is that a caterpillar I see? Corona style isn't just about hair, it's the whole face. Joseph's working the chin curtain and slicking back like the Godfather top. Here's Jackson growing the beard to take the spotlight off his messy hair. And Nathan Vogel, can you imagine what this kid would look like if he hadn't shaved his head this past winter? Chloe, thanks for tossing the salad to really work the volume level. Matthew gets the bobblehead award. You know, you could open the car window to make it flow, just saying. Here's Micah, thanks for the action shots of the manscape. You'd think with the last name Harry you wouldn't bail out on the salad bar, but he goes for the portobello top. Dude, no stripes? Some of you actually look more stylish now. Here's Connor Parr with a bold new look. Why didn't you just go completely bald like Uncle Fester from your school musical days? Tommy Ham's got it long enough to pull back in the man bun. Your look says I care, but I don't care all at the same time. I respect that. For those of you lucky enough to have a family member who cuts hair, Ben shows off his fresh cut sprouts. I'm a little surprised you didn't procrastinate before getting a haircut. Or do you just do that with advisory assignments? Folks, students weren't the only ones that suffered. What, you expected me to roast this one? Yeah, right. Like any good makeover shot, Coach Krupp sends in a blurry before image and a polished after. Boy, for a guy that says never give up, you sure gave up on the hair. Jay Gotti asked his students for hair advice. They wanted the poof to sprout, but he also gave up, and it looks like he let Jack use the clippers. Here's Zacharias, and on days he has Zoom sessions, and on days he's Zoom-free. Man, I wouldn't trust this guy to walk my dog, let alone educate my kid. Oh wait, he does educate my kid. Shout from the past, going for the Rapunzel look is Wolfgram. Boy, if she put all that hair in a top knot, she could reach her goal height of 5'4". Check out Riggles with her lost in the Alaska wilderness look. Wait, doesn't this look familiar? The next thing you know, she's going to be in a mockumentary called Grizzly Bear Queen. Here's another student. Oh, sorry, that's Mr. Paulus. Yeah, your hair still looks good. Syme says to stop showing off. Eccle is either sending in his Corona hairstyle photo or trying to guide an airplane to the gate. You know, I think Eccle would tell you to think of your hair as a metaphor for the Corona crisis. It's out of control. We'll try to manage it and stop the spread. We just need to stay positive. And it really doesn't matter in the end, because you can just cover up your Corona hair with a hat. Congratulations, class of 2020. Here's hoping we meet again, preferably at a hair salon in the near future.
Hey guys, it's Isaac, the local funny man and future inmate at Guantanamo Bay, and I'm here to give my favorite memories of the class of 2020. You know, I'll always remember the class of 2020 as a group of people that have gone from the most hated grade by our peers when we were freshmen to a great group of very cool adults who are probably ready to go into the world and make names for themselves. While I do have a massive list of people to thank, I would like to give a massive thanks to the English teachers of the high school, Mr. Davis, Ms. Mittag, Mr. Eccle, and Ms. Bransford. Through these 4 years, English has remained a fixture of my academic life and has led me to be able to express myself in a more honest and articulate way in both speaking and writing. I would also like to thank...
We're lucky to have another special performance by one of our outstanding performance groups here to perform a reprise of Wait For Me from the musical Hadestown is Mr. DeCaro and Connor Parr.
Thank you. Leonardo da Vinci was an Italian Renaissance painter, sculptor, architect, musician, mathematician, engineer, inventor, anatomist, geologist, cartographer, botanist, and writer. The Da Vinci Award recognizes a male and a female every year who displays the diverse talents and unquenchable curiosity and feverishly inventive imaginations. Now that's a lot to live up to. It is an honor to present this award to Julia Miller, who has exhausted nearly every offering in the visual arts program alongside years in the orchestra program. Because of her diverse interests and talents in science, music, art, and literature, she has this incredibly engaging mind that can discuss the world around her with depth and impressive intellect. Her artistic and musical talents have been an honor to observe, and she brings curiosity, technique, research, reflection, and passion to all areas and interests. Julia is truly a modern Renaissance woman. Then we bring to the stage Connor Parr. I've never had the pleasure of working with Connor in class, but I have admired the many talents from watching him work his magic and humor in school musicals, being literally blown away by his horn playing and his musical talent in both classical and jazz idioms, as well as reading his clever and thought-provoking articulate articles for the Prep Quarterly. How does one find the time to pursue so many different interests with the excellence and ambition that Connor has shown all of us throughout his time at SCPA? Congratulations, Connor.
The Service Award highlights individuals who have proven their commitment to serving others. These individuals work diligently within the SCPA community, often volunteering to aid teachers and work with their peers. They serve with humility and selflessness, focusing not on the accolades and recognition, but rather in helping others. This year, the seniors earning the Service Award are Gracie Klingsborn and Hans Gebauer. Congratulations. SCPA also offers a varsity letter in service for students to earn. Students must earn 100 hours of service within 1 year, and 50 of those hours need to be towards one particular organization or theme. They also must submit photos, write a reflection, and do a presentation on their service work. References are required to validate their quality and commitment to service. This year we have 6 seniors that earned a letter in service. They are Bronwyn Harvey, Gracie Klingsborn, Matthew Nepson, Sydney Sanders, Faith Taylor, and Emma Waring. Congratulations.
The Socrates Award is presented to students who have demonstrated strong abilities in seminar. These students apply the Socratic method effectively in each subject area by supporting their statements with evidence. They are able to articulate cross-discipline knowledge, and they go well beyond recalling information to synthesizing a new perspective and thinking outside of the box. They consistently develop a personal understanding of the material and express it through their inquisitive and questioning nature. And this award is voted on by all upper school faculty. And it's my honor to present these awards to 2 very articulate and curious seniors. The first award is presented to Isaac Woodman. And here are a few statements that faculty offered in support of his nomination. Isaac is not only an excellent at listening, but he's also excellent in synthesizing information. When walking out of a class lecture where you might wonder, has he been really fully engaged? Isaac always shows evidence that he was deeply absorbed and considering questions and issues presented. Often, he would offer insightful questions to his classmate, which is advancing that Socratic thinking. He is innately curious about the world, and a seminar is a better seminar with Isaac's insight and love for a good conversation. The second award is presented to Grace Mullen, and here are a few statements that the faculty offered regarding her participation in Socratic thinking. Grace knows her mind well, and she isn't afraid of looking for the truth, wherever it might lead. She isn't afraid to say she doesn't know and is trying to figure out the big questions. She isn't afraid to disagree, which in a seminar setting does help encourage others to engage in the conversation. So many of the seminars I observed where Grace was in the class, she would get the group going and show both grit and compassion in doing so. Thank you, Grace, for your inquisitive and questioning nature and helping your classmates and teachers gain new perspectives by your willingness to investigate and to wonder.
This year, the SCPA Student Council has sponsored the Class of 2020 Student Choice Awards, awarded for the past 2 years. These awards are intended to be a way for each graduating class to recognize the people that have most impacted their experience here at SCPA. The seniors were asked to nominate 3 males, 3 females, and 2 members of the faculty and staff that they felt contributed the most to the Class of 2020's experience over the years here at St. Croix Prep. There were many worthy people nominated. In fact, over 45 members of the Class of 2020 received votes. And in reading through these comments, as I was tabulating the votes, I was so encouraged at the quality not only of these students' academics, but their character and leadership abilities as well. As I announce the winners of the 3rd SCPA Student Choice Awards, I hope that you recognize that these awards are different and that they were selected by you, the Class of 2020. These winners were selected by the people who were in your classes, that passed you in the halls, that ate lunch with you, competed with you, cheered with you, and maybe even cried with you. You, the Class of 2020, got to see these students in their best moments, in their highs and in their lows, and through it all, these are the students that you have chosen to recognize and honor as the Student Choice Award winners for the Class of 2020. As we present each of these awards, keep in mind that the words that I say are yours, that these words were chosen by you, the Class of 2020, as you described each of these students. The first recipient of this year's SCPA Student Choice Awards goes to a student described this way. This student is always nice and did a lot for our class. They were always willing to help and would often drop their needs to help those who need help. They are very kind, selfless, and always cheerful, and willing to get to know everyone. They always go through with everything that they commit to doing. They have earned a great deal of admiration and respect from their peers for how diligently they work to help ensure every student has a positive experience here at Prep. They are eager to take up the burden of hours of work and stress if it means that our peers can enjoy themselves. They are selfless in all matters. They are a defining figure for our class and a friend to all, and an amazing representative of what a humble leader truly is. They were the, quote, mom of the grade, and they meet all the criteria for someone who should receive this award. Congratulations to Grace Hildrum. The second winner of this year's SCPA Student Choice Awards goes to a student described like this by their peers. Intelligent, smart, academically focused. They are a diligent worker and they get things done. They are fully invested in the challenges that they take on. They bring their competitive spirit and friendly attitude to all of their endeavors. They were consistent in their efforts to improve themselves and those around them. They are a natural leader, even amongst the brightest of students. And they are a well-rounded person of character. Willing to lend a hand to whomever needs it, this individual is a standard for what hard work and character looks like. They speak the truth. They are an amazing friend, and they will make you laugh. They are always funny and always there to make your day better. They are loyal and one that you can always count on to be there for you. They care about you, and while he might be a young Sheldon, he's a great guy who anyone is blessed to call their friend. Congratulations Oliver Yoakum. One of the many traditions that we have here at St. Croix Prep, especially when it comes to coffee house, are the crazy comments overheard in the hallway. Well, unfortunately, there's not a lot going on in the hallway. But thankfully, we can turn to your parents for a little bit of help. Here to present crazy comments overheard at home, Ms. Vidlock and Mr. Williams.
But we thought we would give it a try with what you've been saying with Zoom sessions. You think you're off camera, you think no one's paying attention, but parents are there and they let us know about things that you say, and then we can embarrass you about it later on. So here we are, Ms. V, Mr. Williams, with comments overheard during Zoom sessions. Do you want to start or should I start? We've rehearsed this extensively.
Rehearsals here. I'll start it out. I'm so done with this. What? She wants me to find what in my house? Mom, do we have?
And they didn't include it. I really want to know, like, what were they supposed to have? A pencil? Like, was it something unusual?
Baking soda.
And who is the teacher? Yeah. Senior slide? This is more like senior grind. For some of them, maybe.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there is a reason I wasn't homeschooled.
And I think a reason parents don't want to homeschool.
Right, yes.
I hope my classmates wear their pants to the Zoom meeting. Wait, I hope my teachers wear pants. You'll never know.
Thankfully, there is a mute button. My coworkers aren't respecting my personal space.
That mute button has come in handy. I'm not going to name names, but you know who you are that I've had to mute you. I really miss making fun of literature in class. There's a lot to mock. It's kind of like this. There's no, like, I need the feedback from the audience.
Right, right. Some good laughs here. No, we can't leave the house wearing a Batman mask. We live in the suburbs.
Must be a Woodbury family.
Right. Lara, that's a family from the 129.
Where's the super glue? Oh, never mind. I sat on it. Clean up.
Some children need to come with an off button.
And on Zoom, we have one of those, luckily.
Yes, right.
I'm going to miss that when we're back in the classroom. So,
greetings, class of 2020. It has certainly been a wild ride, culminating in what I would say is one of the most unusual resolutions to the dramatic arc that is your high school career. Stay motivated, stay dedicated, stay inspired. And remember the words of Don Quixote: the time for books is past. Now is the time for adventure. Congratulations.
So for those of you that have been a bit more thoughtful about your responses during attendance, we appreciate that because then that gives us good material to work with. So thank you so much. Mm-hmm. Okay, so here's the first one. What do the initials M&M, the candy, stand for?
Stop making me wake up early. I'm a growing young man who needs my beauty sleep and severely cherish my pillow time.
Ben Silvernail. Yeah, he does need his beauty sleep. Can I say that? What is the Minnesota state apple?
This is a thing? I'm learning a lot from your questions, actually.
Chloe Weinholz.
It's great that our attendance questions still challenge all of you.
Are you a dog person or a cat person?
I'm allergic to both, but I'm a dog person. Cats are scary.
Maddie Marks.
I prefer Cats the Musical.
Connor Parr. It's just got to be quirky. Are you in attendance today?
Are you?
Taylor Joa. Keeping it sarcastic. And here's a fun one. What is your dream car?
Not a minivan.
Hannah Flynn. Thanks, everybody, for all the good material. We'll see you back in Coffee House Action very soon.
Hey, seniors, you worked hard and you made it. Congratulations. Have a great summer and good luck next year.
As our awards ceremony begins to draw to a close, we still have a few awards left to give. So next up, we have our Prep Award, Leadership Award, and Character Award, again, as chosen by the faculty here at St. Croix Prep. To present these awards, we'll go to Ms. Mittag, Mr. Gottschalk, and myself.
It is my honor today to give out the Prep Award. The Prep Award is meant to highlight individuals that encompass the academic drive and grit we hope to inspire here at St. Croix Prep. These individuals we are recognizing today have stood out to the faculty in their effort and determination to make it in and outside of the classroom. For the class of 2020, the Prep Award goes to Madison Marks and Tommy Hamm. Congratulations.
The Leadership Award is given to individuals that exemplify student leadership through the impact they have made here at St. Croix Prep and in the greater community. They are great role models. They give selflessly of their time, talents, and experience. As leaders, they take action. They walk the walk. They set goals and follow the steps necessary to achieve them. They go out of their way to make sure that others have a great experience. They help to make visions a reality. And it is with great appreciation that we present the 2019-2020 SCPA Leadership Award to Grace Hildrum and Oliver Yocum. Congratulations.
The definition of character is a set of qualities or values that shape our thoughts, actions, our reactions, and feelings. The Character Award is being given to students that consistently display trustworthiness, respect, integrity, responsibility, fairness, citizenship, and compassion. They put others before themselves and intuitively do the right thing. It has been my pleasure to get to know both of these students over the last few years, and I couldn't be more proud of both of them. Congratulations to Miriam Cooper and Joseph Baumgarn. Way to go.
Hello, class of 2020. Congratulations on this special milestone. You may be sick of hearing about the unprecedented time and how strange all of this is, but I want to encourage you in two ways. First, I want you to recognize all of the work that you have put in, the relationships that you have formed, and the legacy that you are leaving for the school. That is something that cannot be taken away from you regardless of what is going on globally. Secondly, your experience has the opportunity to shape who you are and what you stand for the rest of your life. I really encourage you to use what you've learned through this time to propel you forward in whatever your pursuits are. This experience will cause some people to lose traction and motivation. I encourage you to be the ones to use this as momentum to push forward and do incredible things. Congratulations, and I look forward to seeing the inspiring work that I know you will do.
This next segment may be more geared for the parents in the audience than the students, as we take a journey down memory lane. Every parent will understand that the days can be long, but the years are short. and it's going to seem like it wasn't that long ago that many of you were taking your first steps and saying your first words. So as we get to enjoy the flashback to see some of these baby photos, take a guess at who is being shown and enjoy the music by the three tenors called Forever Young.
May God bless and keep you always. May your wishes all come true. May you always do for others. Let others do for you. May you build a ladder to the sky. Climb on every rung and may you stay.
Congratulations to the class of 2020. I want to wish you well as you start the next chapter of your journey.
Hi, it's Mr. Krupper, or Coach Krupp, class of 2020. It has been my honor to spend my first year at St. Croix Prep with you fantastic people. Congratulations on finishing a fantastic education. If anything, 2020 has taught us that all conditions are impermanent. So no matter where you are, make the best of each moment and live in it, and be glad. Congratulations again. Look forward to seeing what you do.
We're here to continue to announce the winners of this year's SCPA Student Choice Awards. Congratulations again to our first two winners, Grace Hildrum and Oliver Yoakum, And here we continue presenting the third winner selected by you, the class of 2020. This student can be described by their peers in this way. Over and over again, the class of 2020 described this student as kind, nice, helpful. They go out of their way to make sure everyone is included, regardless of who they are. They can make friends with anyone, and they make a conscious and consistent effort to reach out to students who feel alone or down. Their heart is what makes them truly special. They always strive to do the right thing in their personal life, academics, and sports. They speak up for what they believe in, and they always assumed a position of leadership when it came to organizing the class. And while they can be heard from a mile away, they have a lot to say and aren't shy about using their voice to advocate for others. This student has grown so much over the 4 years, and their enthusiasm and team spirit cannot be matched. Congratulations, Gracie Klingsborn. The next recipient of the 2020 SCPA Student Choice Award goes to a student described in this way by their peers. This student is willing to stick up for others and always does their best. They are the voice we all need to hear when we need something. They speak their truth and work hard. They brought new perspectives and work through obstacles and is relentless in their pursuit to acquire more skills. They are accomplished. Called by many for being a natural leader, this student helped create a community where all felt accepted. Congratulations, Hans Gebauer. Advisory here at St. Croix Prep can be a special time of bonding, not only between the class of 2020, but also between members of that class and their particular advisor. This year, the senior advisors wanted to get together and do something special for the class of 2020. And so here they are, performing "Oh, the Places You Will Go."
Hi, class of 2020. Your senior advisors have a reading for you today. You may be familiar with the book, "Oh, the Places You'll Go" by Dr. Seuss.
Congratulations, today is your day. You're off to great places, you're off and away. You have brains in your head, you have feet in your shoes, and you can steer yourself any direction you choose. You're on your own, and you know what you know, and you are the guy who will decide where to go. You look up and down streets, look them over with care. About some you'll say, "I don't choose to go there." With your head full of brains and your shoes full of feet, you're too smart to go down any not-so-good street. And you may not find any you want to go down. In that case, of course, you'll head straight out of town.
It's opener there in the wide open air. Out there, things can happen and frequently do to people as brainy and footsy as you. And then things start to happen. Don't worry, don't stew. Just go right along. You'll start happening too. Oh, the places you'll go. You'll be on your way up. You'll be seeing great sights. You'll join the high flyers who soar to high heights. You won't lag behind because you'll have the speed. You'll pass the whole gang and you'll soon take the lead. Wherever you fly, you'll be best of the best. Wherever you go, you will top all of the rest. Except when you don't, because sometimes you won't.
I'm sorry to say so, but sadly it's true that bang-ups and hang-ups can happen to you. You can get all hung up in a prickly perch, and your gang will fly on. You'll be left in a lurch. You'll come down from the lurch with an unpleasant bump, and the chances are then that you'll be in a slump. And when you're in a slump, you're not in for much fun. Unslumping yourself is not easily done. You will come to a place where the streets are not marked. Some windows are lighted, but mostly they're dark. A place you could sprain both your elbow and chin. Do you dare to stay out? Do you dare to go in? How much can you lose and how much can you win? And if you go in, should you turn left or right? Or right in 3/4? Or maybe not quite? Or go around back and sneak in from behind? Simple it's not, I'm afraid you will find, for a mind maker upper to make up his mind. You can get so confused that you'll start in a race down long wiggled roads at a breaknecking pace and grind on for miles across weirdish wild space, headed, I fear, toward a most useless place.
The waiting place. For people just waiting. Waiting for a train to go, or a bus to come, or a plane to go, or the mail to come, or the rain to go, or the phone to ring, or the snow to snow. Or waiting around for a yes or no, or waiting for their hair to grow. Everyone is just waiting, waiting for the fish to bite, or waiting for wind to fly a kite, or waiting around for a Friday night, or waiting perhaps for their Uncle Jake, or a pot to boil, or a better break, or a string of pearls, or a pair of pants, or a wig of curls, or another chance. Everyone is just waiting. But no, that's not for you.
Somehow you'll escape all that waiting and staying. You'll find the bright places where boom bands are playing. With banner flip-flapping, once more you'll ride high, ready for anything under the sky. Ready because you're that kind of guy or girl. Oh, the places you'll go, there'll be fun to be done. There are points to be scored. There are games to be won. And the magical things you can do with that ball will make you the winningest winner of all. Fame, you'll be as famous can be, with the whole world watching you win on TV. Except when they don't, because sometimes they won't. I'm afraid that sometimes you'll play lonely games too, games you can't win, because you'll play against you. All alone, whether you like it or not, alone will be something. You'll be quite a lot. And when you're alone, there's a very good chance you'll meet things that scare you right out of your pants. There are some down the road between hither and yon that can scare you so much you won't want to go on.
But on you will go, though the weather be foul. On you will go, though your enemies prowl. On you will go, though the hackencracks howl. Onward up many a frightening creek, though your arms may get sore and your sneakers may leak. On and on you will hike, and I know you'll hike far and face up to your problems, whatever they are. You'll get mixed up, of course, as you already know. You'll get mixed up with many strange birds as you go. So be sure when you step, step with care and great tact. And remember that life's a great balancing act. Just never forget to be dexterous and deft, and never mix up your right foot with your left. And will you succeed? Yes, you will indeed. 98.75% guaranteed. Kid, you'll move mountains.
Kid, you'll move mountains.
Kid, you'll move mountains.
So be your name Buxbum or Bixby or Bray or Mordecai Alley Van Allen O'Shea. You're off to great places. Today is your day. Your mountain is waiting, so get on your way.
Hey seniors, graduates, class of 2020, I just want to take a minute to tell you how thankful I am for the time I've had with you over these last few years. You are a group of students who motivated teachers to simply be their best. And sometimes, let's face it, it's because you didn't make things easy. You questioned why, you pushed for change, and honestly, these are things that make me so proud of you, especially today. You are game changers. And right now, this moment we're in, this so very strange moment we're in, I think just pushes that further because you are going to make something of this moment. Okay? I'm excited for this group to keep asking why and to keep pushing new boundaries. That's what you do. But this place will still be a home that you can come back to. My congrats to the class of 2020. I am so very proud of you and I'm wishing you the best.
As a part of the Student Choice Awards, students are asked to nominate two teachers or staff members that they felt impacted their time here at St. Croix Prep. This year, the first recipient of this award is described by the class of 2020 in this way. This teacher was chosen because they are passionate about their subject and make class fun and engaging. They make connections with their students. They have been incredibly patient and helpful as a teacher, and quote, they still stop me in the hallways to say hi and talk about life, end quote. They have impacted students' time here at SCPA because they have helped, quote, me realize that life can be full of a wide variety of experiences. Every time I talk to them, they have a new fact or a new story to share, end quote. They are so enthusiastic and passionate about their field and have so many great and funny stories to share. It's their passion that makes them an amazing teacher. Congratulations to Dr. Sandy Schreier. The next winner of the Faculty Award and the Student Choice Awards 2020 goes to a teacher described by the class of 2020 in this way. This teacher has always been so invested in their students. They are a great teacher and are very easy to talk to about things that aren't directly related to their class. They always seem open for a conversation. Quote, not only have they affected me in my academics, but also in service. Their commitment to service is incredible, and they have impacted me in volunteering so much. They helped me learn to love service, end quote. Students can tell that they generally care about, this teacher generally cares about them and wants them to succeed. They are always making sure that the class of 2020 is on time and out together and does whatever is needed to guide people on the right path. This teacher goes above and beyond to help the students and make sure that they are not only doing well in their academics, but in all aspects of their life. Students said that this teacher cares a lot. They are a very kind person, and the class of 2020 liked their lightheartedness and sarcasm and said that they are basically the whole class's mom. Congratulations to Karen Bidlock.
One of my favorite memories about the class of 2020 was this thing that started, I want to say, around April of last year. Somebody would say something, and then in response, somebody starts to clap, and then the whole class breaks into applause. And at first, it kind of had like this mocking tone to it that I didn't particularly care for. So I said, come on, guys, let's not do that. But which didn't happen. You guys kept on doing it. But what I noticed was that bit by bit, the timing and the tone of it sort of shifted so that eventually it became this genuine celebration of something insightful or important that somebody had said. And so to me, that really encapsulates the whole spirit of the class of 2020. You know, not taking yourself too seriously, but at the same time, you know, demonstrating that camaraderie and having your heart in the right place.
Hi, this is Miss Bransford, and today I have the honor of bestowing scholarships on some of our St. Croix Prep seniors. These seniors have been selected by the St. Croix Prep faculty. We came together and voted. And these students will be awarded $450 each, which we hope will help get them started on their adventures in college. So there are three scholarships today, one for academics, one for character, and one for leadership. The first scholarship is for academics. It is awarded to someone who has impressed us consistently with her dedication to hard work and her perseverance and her calm but totally dedicated personality in class and in sports too. The academic scholarships this year goes to Grace Mullen. Congratulations, Grace. The character scholarship this year is awarded to someone who has impressed us with her commitment to service. She serves the school community, and she also serves the larger community. In fact, she has traveled multiple times to foreign countries to serve, and she does so with humility and modesty and kindness. She is a servant leader and shows great character in every interaction that she has. The character scholarship this year is awarded to senior Emma Wearing. Congratulations, Emma. The Leadership Scholarship this year is awarded to someone who has her hand in seemingly every event at St. Croix Prep. She is a quiet leader, but she is also a leader who knows how to get things done. She leads by example and shows great character in everything that she does. This year's Leadership Scholarship is awarded to senior Grace Hildrum. Again, on behalf of St. Croix Preparatory Academy and St. Croix Prep's faculty and staff, we are so honored to award these scholarships to Grace Hildrum, Emma Wearing, and Grace Mullen. Congratulations. Thank you.
My advice for the class of 2020 is to not let the way your senior year ended define your accomplishments over the last 12 years. You guys have done amazing things and you've worked really hard for a really long time. So it's okay to be frustrated and be sad with how it's ending up right now, but don't let that impede your ability to move forward in the fall in college and just go forth and do really good things in the future. We're excited to see where you all end up and what you do. And just don't dwell on the past. Move forward, onward, and upward.
The next recipient of the 2020 Student Choice Awards goes to a student described by their peers in this way. This student is the type of friend we all strive to have and will go out of their way to make your day amazing. They achieved standout status in academics, athletics, and extracurriculars, which demonstrates their consistent instinct to always push hard to accomplish any goal. Their focus and dedication is inspiring. They might not be the loudest, but they certainly leave a mark on everyone they meet. They find purpose in helping others and deeply cares for those that they love. They exemplify our school's values and is an excellent role model as we all strive to be people of integrity, joy, and depth. Congratulations, Clara Brecker. The next recipient of the SCPA Student Choice Awards for 2020 is a student described in this manner. This student is compassionate to everyone that they meet. They never hesitate to help someone out on a topic that they don't understand and excels in school individually. They cheer people up and will be a force for good wherever they can. They are incredibly smart, helpful, and have such a great personality. They best represent the SCPA class of 2020 because of their character and their academic success. They always push themselves and find success academically. They also are a great person with strong values and is kind to everyone around them. Congratulations, Jackson Moffitt. The last recipient for this year's Student Choice Awards goes to a student described in this manner. This student's peers consistently describe them as unique and inclusive. They are sweet, outgoing, loud, and is not afraid to make their voice heard. They always brought new perspectives to any conversation and were easy to talk to. They are kind to everyone and a good example of character at SCPA. They bring a great energy to the group and are always there to help. They are a talented artist. They never fail to lift people up if they are feeling down. And they bring life to the party wherever they go. Most importantly, your day is always better by simply being around them. Congratulations, Sunsuki Tao.
Congratulations on all of your accomplishments. Your hard work and determination is paid off. I am going to remember the class of 2020 for their passion. Their passion and determination in everything that they did, whether it was in activities or classwork, whether it was debating the morality of Frankenstein's creature in Frankenstein or the enthusiasm for dress-up days during homecoming week. The class of 2020 has passion. My favorite memories go back to when I met a lot of you in middle school, where the passion showed through, whether it was, you know, singing Conjunction Junction in Schoolhouse Rock or fighting monsters in Monster Hunters or playing animals in Wind in the Willows. The class of 2020 just had so much passion and so much willingness to try new things. And I think that that passion that you guys have is going to serve you well in life. I hope that wherever life leads you, you are able to find joy and fulfillment and success in whatever that means for you. And know that everybody here at St. Croix Prep is rooting for you as you go out into the world. Congratulations.
Well, here's the moment that you've all been waiting for. Here is this year's presentation of the Senior Slideshow. A special thanks goes out to Gracie Klingsborn and Ben Bidlin, along with Izzy Gardner, for their hard work on putting together and capturing the memories of the class of 2020. Enjoy.
This will all make sense when I am older. Someday I will see that this makes sense. One day when I'm old and wise, I'll think back and realize that these were all completely normal events.
Just call on me, brother, when you need a hand. We all need somebody to lean on. I just might have a problem that you'll understand. We all need somebody to lean on.
Things are changing, it seems strange, and I need to figure this out. You've got your life, I got mine, but you're all I cared about. Yesterday we were laughing, today I'm left here asking, where is all the time gone now? I'm left alone somehow, growing up and getting.
Jump, you don't feel the fall. Hope when the water rises, you build a wall. Hope when the crowd screams out, you're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. Hope that you fall in love and it hurts so bad.
Say
I did it. lost where I live. Hope that you spend your days, but they all add up. I'll say
about the class of 2020, I'm reminded of imaginary numbers. Now, I realize most of you are thinking, what? I'm not a number. I'm definitely not an imaginary number. But to me, imaginary numbers are amazing. They're a creative solution to what was once thought to be an unsolvable problem. However, I know that some of you do not feel the same way about imaginary numbers as I do. You think that they're something stupid, used to solve problems no one really cares about. Let me give you a couple examples. So, senior class, you were against the school's dress code. You hated the blue-collared shirts, and you thought it was unfair. So, to protest this, you wore crazy socks. You were also confronted with the possibility going the entire school day without being able to text or Snapchat or whatever else you do with your phones. So, instead of simply giving in and keeping your cell phones and technology away for 8 full hours, you slyly used your Apple Watches or hid your phones in your pockets. Things got tough towards the end of the year. The whole world pretty much went into quarantine. but it gave me great comfort to know that you were still out there solving problems. You were able to sleep in while still getting to school on time. You were able to attend class and chat behind our backs. You were able to be in class, but not really be in class. Like, I could see your picture, I could see your name, but were you really there? So, class of 2020, keep it up, keep solving problems, and consider using your problem-solving powers for good every once in a while. Congratulations.
As we end our evening in these virtual award ceremony, we conclude with a message from Executive Director, Mr. John Gutierrez.
Hi everyone, Mr. Gutierrez here. Thank you for inviting me to the 7th Annual Award Ceremony. This is the first one that's being done virtually, and we all know the reasons why. Nonetheless, we want to honor the tradition of recognizing the outstanding achievements of individuals within our community, and you certainly deserve it. This ceremony, these awards, it is our applause for you. We recognize that you are passionate. Each and every one of you are passionate. Unique in your own way. Why do you play an instrument or sing? What is it about Latin or art? Science or English for that matter? You are unique. There is no one else like you. And those passions are unique as well. It is because of all of your yesterdays and all of the journeys of today. The goals and the dreams that you have, they are yours, and they are only yours. You are passionate. You are also disciplined. I mean, everybody has goals and dreams, but you have actually done something to accomplish them. Very intentionally, you've done the work to accomplish things that are valuable to you. These awards represent that. No one can take them away. No one can diminish the work. You have done it. You have accomplished great things. Each day you receive a gift that is rarely acknowledged, but always received. It is the gift of time. And you have used the gift of time to excel to a measure of distinction. You are disciplined. And finally, you are persevering. Lord knows in these times, you are indeed persevering. Just remember, think of the times when you were frustrated. Think of the times when you were anxious, filled with anxiety, challenged beyond what you thought you could do, the times that you wanted to quit, the times that you thought you would fail and you might not measure up. What did you do? You continued, you pressed on, you worked harder, and you finished. You didn't conform to the naysayers. You are persevering. To you, honestly, I am amazed, I'm in awe, and I'm inspired. How did you do it? Well, I know how you did it, and we all know how you did it. And for that reason, we sincerely thank you. There was nothing mysterious or magical about what you did. It was just plain hard work. And so to you, we are grateful because you have emulated what we all try to continue to do in our lives. To all of you, congratulations. Well done.
That concludes our award ceremonies this evening for the class of 2020. Thank you for tuning in and watching as we try to celebrate the successes and the victories of the class of 2020. To the class of 2020, on behalf of all the faculty and staff here at St. Croix Prep, thank you. Thank you for your hard work, for your perseverance, and your dedication to each other and to St. Croix Prep. Congratulations.